destroy me, you little pest. And just like that, Blues gets cut down to size. What's good, everyone? Welcome back to another Throwback Tuesday. Now, I know it's been a minute since I last recorded anything for Tuesday, but here we are, jumping into some Rockman and Forte. I'm playing a translated version of the Mega Man and Bass game that we never got, and which only came out for Japan only. Pretty much this was, I call this 7.5. Yeah, Mega Man 7.5. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play through with Rockman, and then I'm gonna play through with Bass, or with Forte, since he's called Bass. Even though it'd be a lot smarter to just call him Bass, but So here we go. I'm not gonna lie, the translation is on point so far from what it looks like. We got this game instead of getting it on the Famicom, or the Super Famicom, excuse me. We got it for the Game Boy Advance. Now, I was thinking about playing that one for Handheld Sunday, but there are a bunch of other games that I have that I also want to play for the channel for Sunday, handheld-wise. I did make a straw poll for it, too, so whenever you guys get a chance, look, the link will be in the description. So, but pretty much you had the this was the first time that you actually got to play with Bass storyline wise outside of the Mega Man Robot Master Fighter, if that can even be called a robot a fighter. It was more like a co-op game, since they put you up against all the bosses. Oh, it didn't drop health. Normally, not health, an extra life. Normally, I get an extra life out of that, but I guess today is not the day. Hopefully you guys also like the layout, the overlay that I'm using as well. So, like I said, I'm doing some new stuff with certain games and, well, console-wise and all that, but the intro stage can be a pain sometimes. This is why, because the pushing ring. Fuck. Oh my god. Okay, he didn't respond, thank god. Just gotta be really careful. Oh, look, it's Blues. Far enough, King. First Dr. Wiley's lab, now the museum. I've now attained all the blueprints of your combat robots. With this data, I can assemble an invincible mechanoid army. Since you're a robot, you can join me if you want. Looks like your friends come to help you. Bah, I haven't got time to spend on you two. You ain't going anywhere, King. Enough! You annoy me, you little pest. And just like that, Blues gets cut down to size. Blues! This is nothing. It's just a flesh wound. Leave this to me. Head back to Dr. Light and get yourself patched up. So that's the new antagonist. It would be simple to kill you right here and now, but I'm afraid I must see it. I must see it assembling my great king army. I shall let the green devil take care of you. This is an easy boss fight, because he just kind of stands there. Alright, let's go ahead and save. I'm going to go ahead and overwrite the file that I have now. So pretty much, you have different paths that you can take, and they all lead somewhere. Different robot masters, all that. Some you might recognize, like Gravity Man from Mega Man 8, and of course Tango Man's in here as well. But also you have, you can go to Auto Shop, you get to pick up these database discs to get information on a lot of the robot masters, and then some from the past, all that other stuff. Let's go ahead and jump right into the first boss thing. Hold me. I'm not gonna lie, the music here is phenomenal. The big difference between Rockman and Forte is that Rockman can charge up his Buster, he cannot do a dash. I mean, he has his slide. You want to count that as a dash, but it's not like a little legitimate forward dash like what Mega Man X can do. Damn. And he can't double jump. That's fine. Wow. I kind of find a lot of the stains here interesting in this game compared to the other Mega Man games, but then again, they all, in one way or another, have a unique way of sticking out. That's one thing you gotta worry about. God. Alright, this is gonna be a hard boss fight. Such a dick move. But there we go. First boss down. I think I'm gonna do two bosses to kind of be safe. And then put an end to the video. But we'll see. Also, sorry if the webcam looks like it's cramped up in there. You know, like I said, I'm trying something new, and last thing I wanted to do was make it seem like it was all, how would I put it? It was in the way of anything, so. So, here we are. Burner Man. Alive. bit of Search Man with the whole jungle type thing. We'll be right back. clock. This is where I get the fire stick and stuff, so... Yeah, the fire instantly kills you in this stage, too, so... I'm sorry if I'm not talking as much. I should be explaining more, but honestly, I only know a little bit about this game. Fuck! This is his weakness, but he is going to push out a lot of damage. Like that, see? So, take two. Shit, we did it. Damn. I didn't think I was gonna get it. I thought I was gonna die. Alright. Holy shit. Wave burner. Holy crap, man. Awesome. I am saving here. Stay tuned for more videos to come tonight and tomorrow, because I still gotta do a Samurai Champloo video, and then I got some editing to do for the next couple of videos for Dark Souls, Dead Rising 2, and so on. But also check out the straw poll in the description for Handheld Sunday. That's gonna be going on until Saturday. So get your votes in while you can. The reason why I'm doing the straw poll is mainly because I didn't want to just jump into a game series that, you know, I'm already playing one game and then I'm playing the same game or the same franchise. So I wanted to give a little bit of everyone a chance. So get your votes in while you can. I'll see you guys in the next couple of videos.